welcome to Sculling Academy, where I help people like you who are interested in sculling to realise their potential. My name's Steve Walker.
And I'm also the author of How to Win, The Sports Competitor's Guide to Success. And I've been successful sculling and rowing, and today I'm going to teach you how to scull. Let's go and have a go. Always put your shore side scull in first. Then there's a bit of extra weight on this side to stop the boat tipping over. Even experienced people sometimes make this mistake and they put their oar in the oar lock the wrong way round. There's pitch built into the gate here, 4 degrees, and if you turn it round the other way, now it's -4 degrees. Okay, and if you do the gate up and try and row with that, you're going to have a lot of difficulty. So the first thing to teach you is how to get into the boat. I've put my shore side scull in there first, so the boat's leaning onto the stage, and I'm going to put this one in next. Now the most important thing is to keep my weight over here between the boat and the stage. If I put my weight over that side, leaning over like that, then I'm quite likely to tip the whole thing in. So I must keep my weight here. So I keep my hand on the rigger and my leg outside like that, and then I can reach this and my weight is still over here. Put my blade in, still keeping my weight on the rigger here, a leg over that side, and do the gate up. If I let it float towards me, it's a bit closer to me, so it's easier to get hold of, and then I can push it round like that. Now, getting in. Hold your hands together, the handles together like this, one above the other, and put your foot in the middle of the boat. And keep your weight again on this side, and keep that blade that's in the water, keep it on the water. Some people quite often press down there, and that takes the blade off the water and makes the boat more unstable. Once you lift it up, you feel quite stable. And then keeping your weight on one leg, you sit down. Now, I usually take my shoes off before I get into the boat, but you can do it when you're in the boat. But keep hold of the handles all the time, like this, and keep them up. Feet in. Okay, so now you're ready to push off. And boats aren't built to go sideways. Obviously, they're designed to go forwards. And if you just push sideways, you won't go very far. So it's a good idea to angle the boat so it's out there in the bows and in at the stern. And instead of now pushing sideways, I push that way. And then I just wait. And you have to have patience now. Wait until the blade is off the stage. Or you could push yourself along to the end of the stage, and that would work equally well. And then you sit with your hands in this area. This is the safe area. Here, it's virtually impossible to turn the boat over. If you keep your blades on the water, keep the handles up, you have got yourself a little trimaran. Something supporting the boat on each side. What you need to do now is to just move your hands around and get the feeling of what it's like to lift and lower your hands alternately, tipping the boat like that. And you should do it at this point here and there as well. Just get used to feeling what it's like. It's a familiarity with the boat and what happens to it, what happens when you lift and lower your handles. And I'm going to teach you how not to fall in. This is very important. The next thing is to try just pressing the handles down a little bit and tip the boat from side to side. Keep the handles connected and don't press down too far, and then the boat will only go a small amount. And tip it from side to side. You notice that the blade fills up with water and it has to empty before it'll come off the water, and then it goes over to the other side. And then you can press your hands down a bit further and tip the boat further, like that. And this is quite alarming at first when you do it, so don't go too hard. Don't push your hands down too far. Just do it a little bit and build up your confidence this way. So I think it's very important to teach people how not to fall in.
You see, I think I'm a bit like you. I mean, when I first learned to scull in a boat like this, the only advice that I was given was never to let go of the handles. This is to prevent me falling in. You didn't want to fall in where I learned to row, on the dock in Birkenhead, because, well, you had to go and have your stomach pumped if you did fall in there at the local hospital.
A lot of people will do capsize drills, which is teaching people how to fall in and then how to get back in the boat again. I prefer to teach people not to fall in.
And that is what I will be teaching in the next video. So, fill in the form below, click on the submit button, and I'll send you an email with a link to the next video in it. And do me a favour, if you see any like buttons around this video anywhere, please click on one of them, or all of them. Better still, leave a comment. If you've learned something that you didn't know, or there is something else that you would like to know that I haven't covered yet, then please leave a comment. And if you've had a light bulb moment where you've suddenly realised what you've been doing wrong, or something that's helped you a lot with your sculling, then please comment about it. Let's have a conversation. So fill in the form below, click on the submit button, and I'll see you on the other side.